Hey esteemed, welcome to ACE Academy. I'm Harini and today we'll be looking at the current affairs of March 21. So without much delay, let's get into the first question. So the first question is, when is the International Day of Happiness observed? So the answer is option C. So we celebrate the International Day of Happiness on 20th of March. And the theme of the International Day of Happiness is happiness for all, forever. Then moving on to the next question. So the second question is, Prime Minister Mark Rutte has won the 2021 presidential election to be sworn in for the fourth state term. He is the Prime Minister of which country? So the answer is option D, Netherlands. So Mark Rutte is the Prime Minister of Netherlands. Then moving on to the next question. So the third question is, which country is developing the largest floating solar farm in the world to curb climatic change? So the answer is option D, Singapore. So Singapore is developing the world's largest floating solar farm. Then moving on to the next question. So the fourth question is, which country has signed the International Solar Alliance Framework Agreement? So the answer is option A, Italy. So Italy has signed the International Solar Alliance Framework Agreement, and it is the alliance of 121 countries, most of the countries being sunshine countries, which lie either completely or partly between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. And the headquarters of the ISA is located in Gurugram. And the founder of International Solar Alliance is Narendra Modi. And International Solar Alliance was founded on 30th November 2015. Then moving on to the next question. So the fifth question is, KRAS is a joint venture between Kalyani Group of India and Rafael Advanced Defense System of which country? So the answer is option D, Israel. So KRAS is a joint venture between Kalyani Group of India and the Rafael Advanced System of Israel, and KRAS stands for Kalyani Rafael Advanced System, and the chairman of Kalyani Rafael Advanced System is Baba Kalyani. And KRAS and Rafael Advanced Defense System, they both have together released the first batch of medium-range surface-to-surface air missile kits. Then moving on to the next question. So the sixth question is, which of the following state or union territory recently launched initiative Awam Ki Baat, a radio program? So the answer is option D, Jammu and Kashmir. So Jammu and Kashmir has recently launched a radio program called Awam Ki Baat, and it is an initiative by the governor of Jammu and Kashmir, Manoj Sinha. So it is an initiative by Manoj Sinha. It was initiated at Raj Bhavan in Jammu. Then moving on to the next question. So the seventh question is, the 6th India-Brazil South Africa Women's Forum was held in virtual format recently. Who was the chairperson of the meeting? So the answer is option D, Smriti Zubin Irani. So recently 6th India-Brazil South Africa Women's Forum was held and it was chaired by Smriti Zubin Irani. Then moving on to the next question. And the 8th question is, for the year 2021, what is the GDP rate estimated for India by the UN body, UN Conference on Trade and Development? So the answer is option C, 5%. So the GDP rate estimated for India by the UN body, UN Conference on Trade and Development is 5%. Then moving on to the next question. So the 9th question is, what is the new wholly owned subsidiary set up by Punjab National Bank to manage its credit card business? So the answer is option C, Punjab National Bank Cards and Service Limited, PNB Cards and Service Limited. And the Chief Executive Officer of Punjab National Bank is Mallikarjuna Rao. Then moving on to the next question. So the 10th question is, as per Moody's Analytics, what is the projected GDP growth rate of India in the calendar year 2021? So the answer is option D, 12%. So as per Moody's Analytics, the projected GDP growth rate of India in the calendar year 2021 is 12%. Then moving on to the next question. So the 11th question is, the World Oral Health Day is marked annually on which date? So the answer is option B, 20th of March. And the theme of the World Oral Health Day is, be proud of your mouth. Then moving on to the next question. So the 12th question is, which is the first Afghanistan player to score a double century in test cricket? So the answer is option D, Hashmatullah Shahidi. So Hashmatullah Shahidi is the first Afghanistan player to score a double century in test cricket. Then moving on to the next question. So the 13th question is, the World Frog Day is observed on which day of the year? So the answer is option B, 20th of March. So we celebrate World Frog Day on 20th of March. Then moving on to the next question. So the 14th question is, which day of the year is celebrated as the World Sparrow Day? So the answer is option A, 20th of March. So we celebrate the World Sparrow Day on 20th of March. And the theme of the World Sparrow Day is I love sparrows. So the theme is I love sparrows. Then moving on to the next question. So the 15th question is, who has been appointed as the chairman of the Stop TB Partnership Board? So the answer is option B, Harshvardhan. So Harshvardhan has been appointed as the chairman of the Stop TB Partnership Board, and Harshvardhan is the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare. Then moving on to the next question. So the 16th question is, with which bank the IOCL has inked India's first LIBOR alternative rate deal? So the answer is option A, State Bank of India. So with State Bank of India, IOCL. IOCL full form is Indian Oil Corporation Limited. So Indian Oil Corporation Limited has inked India's first LIBOR alternative deal. And the Chief Executive Officer of State Bank of India is Dinesh Kumar Khara. And the Chief Executive Officer of Indian Oil Corporation Limited is Shrikant Madhav Vaidya. So, the Chief Executive Officer of Indian Oil Corporation Limited is Shrikant Madhav Vaidya. And the full form of LIBOR is London Interbank Offer Rate. And the full form of LIBOR is London Interbank Offer Rate. And it is the global reference rate for unsecured short-term borrowing in interbank market. Then moving on to the next question. So the 17th question is, the Ministry of Defense has inked an agreement with which company for the supply of 4,960 million 2T anti-tank guided missile to the Indian Army? So the answer is option C, Bharat Dynamics Limited. So Bharat Dynamics Limited has inked an agreement with the Ministry of Defense to supply the 4,960 million 2T anti-tank guided missile to Indian Army. And the chairman of Bharat Dynamics Limited is Siddharth Mishra. Then moving on to the next question. So the 18th question is, which language day is observed on March 20 every year? So the answer is option C, French language day. So French language day is observed on March 20 every year. Then moving on to the next question. So the 19th question is, Samia Sulu Hassan has sworn in as the first female president of which country? So the answer is option C, Tanzania. So Samia Sulu Hassan has sworn in as the first female president of Tanzania, and she is the first female leader of East African country. Then moving on to the next question. So the last question is, India's Avinash Sable is associated with which sports? So the answer is option D, athletics. So Avinash Sable is associated with athletics. He has set a new national record in men's 3000 meter steeplechase in the ongoing Federation Cup Senior National Athletics Championship in. So that's it, we are done for the day, and thank you for watching our video. And if you think that we are doing good, please let us know in the comment section below, because it means a lot to us. And meet you in my next video. Till then, bye. It's me, Harini, signing off.